In a recent video, we talked about the roughness of some common engineered surfaces. Roughness can mean a lot of things, but in surface texture measurement, it has a very specific meaning. Here's a two-dimensional profile of a surface, like you might have measured with a stylus. We call this the raw measurement. It's a record of the movement of the stylus as it passed over the surface. So is this the surface roughness? Not exactly. We've talked about how surface texture data consists of many spatial wavelengths, and that we can filter the data based on those wavelengths to understand it better. To get to the roughness, we need to define which spatial wavelengths we are referring to as roughness. First, we'll remove the largest overall shape of the surface, such as tilt or curvature. We do this by removing a reference geometry. Next, we'll filter out the very short spatial wavelengths. These might be small shapes that aren't relevant to the application, or spiky data that may be noise. This short spatial wavelength filter will be applied at the roughness short filter cutoff wavelength, or lambda s, and this will define one end of our roughness band. Once the short filter is applied, we call the remaining data the primary profile. Now, we need to provide an upper limit for the roughness band. We do that by applying a long spatial wavelength filter, which divides the primary profile data into short spatial wavelength roughness and longer spatial wavelength waviness. The long filter will be applied at the roughness long wavelength cutoff, or lambda c. After applying the short filter and the long filter, the remaining profile data is what we call the roughness profile. Before we move on to 3D texture, Michigan Metrology has been measuring surfaces for thousands of clients for almost 30 years now. Visit MitchMet.com to learn how we can help you with your 3D surface texture measurements, and to check out all of our surface texture reference material. There aren't standard values for which spatial wavelengths are called roughness. What is roughness for an optical surface, say, may be imperceivable for a metal component. The values we choose for lambda s and lambda c should be chosen based on the application. Standards like ASME's B46.1 provide guidelines for how to select the spatial wavelength. But, regardless of the values, when we specify and calculate roughness parameters, such as RA, average roughness, we must state the filter cutoffs. An RA value without the filter cutoff wavelengths is basically meaningless. Now, let's look at a 3D aerial measurement of surface texture, like you might see from an optical profiler. Are we looking at 3D surface roughness? It would be better to call it 3D surface texture. In the 3D measurement world, rather than the terms roughness and waviness, we define as many spatial wavelength bands as we need to support a particular application. As with 2D measurements, we start by removing the reference geometry. Then, we apply a short wavelength limit, or S filter, and a long wavelength limit, or L filter. The texture we'll analyze will be composed of the spatial wavelengths between the filters. We call this the SL surface, and we can have as many as we need for the application. In our next video, we will look at how we define average roughness, one of the most common surface roughness parameters. Michigan Metrology provides 3D surface roughness measurement to help manufacturers understand the surface texture of their components. Find out how we can help you with your surface texture measurement needs.